My name is Tony. I'm age 55. I'm from Clinton, Tennessee, and I have very large growths on my face. They're huge nodules, sometimes pus-filled, and it gives off an awful smell.
Like rancid fish oil.
5 years ago, I had taken medicine for help with cardiac health, but its side effects were severe flushing. And I felt things start to happen with my nose. It would feel like things were bubbling. And then these growths started into just rapid expansion. Doctors here in the area were not able to give me any solutions. And nobody likes to be told, oh, you have a condition. Good luck with that. These nodules are becoming so heavy that it's occluding my breathing. So if I'm breathing hard, my nose will actually collapse. And it's this position in order to keep breathing. I have to keep all of this open or I suffocate. In order to get any kind of rest, I suffer with apnea, but the nostrils are so incredibly heavy that as soon as I relax, they'll close in and I will never get rest unless I can somehow have some external means of breathing. There are things that I have to negotiate with this nose. This is how we have to fit this guy on. And this is the apparatus I have to wear tightly so it seals around and pushes these out, seals around my nostrils. So it turns out automatically. I have a CPAP to help me sleep. So it pushes all of this out of the way and seals. My breathing is, if I couldn't have help from a CPAP machine, I would not sleep. There's no way in relaxing to keep this from closing off, and I would be constantly woken up. This is what I have to do to get any kind of rest. So it's another adaptation that I have to do in order to get any kind of sleep. I don't think I'm being challenged by God with this. Things happen to everybody. And so this just happens to be what I'm carrying. St. Paul had his thorn in the flesh. This is probably mine. And so in my love for God isn't, my understanding isn't this. That God afflicts people with anything. These things happen. We live in a fallen world and all kinds of awful things happen. It does nothing for me to shake my fist at God and say, how dare you? I had everything perfectly lined up. No, these things happen.
I'm blessed to be at Dr. Lee's office this morning, and we're going to see if she can help me with my crazy looking nose.
All right, Dr. Lee will be right in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
If I can't get this done today, my hopes are dimming that I can have anything that resembles a normal life.
Well, good morning.
Hi, it's so
I'm
good
Sandra.
To meet you.
I'm Sandra, it's nice to meet you. Wow, look at your nose.
I know.
You're looking so lovely, too.
Thank you.
What a dapper dresser you are. Well, I think we know what you're here for. You have rhinophyma. Let me take a look at you here. Oh, it's like it's covered your nostril here.
Yeah, it's difficult to breathe.
Yeah, how long have you been dealing with it?
It started about 5 years ago when I started medicine for its cardiac benefits.
Okay,
the side effects were horrible flushing.
Yes.
And I felt this almost like bubbling, crackling in my nose.
Wow, that's scary.
Yeah, and so I thought maybe there's an association that it kickstarted this. And
People want to know why something's happened. Oftentimes, it's really hard for people to accept that there was nothing that they could have done to prevent this. But it's a good thing that I do know a good amount about Tony's condition, but we do have to talk about a few things before we proceed.
This looks like it's pretty normal right here. Your tip of your nose here?
Sure.
Right? It just kind of starts right up here. And these are just like little grapes hanging off of your nose here. So it's got me excited for you. I see your nose under there.
Oh, it's
fantastic. I see it already. But the main thing that I'm concerned about is it looks like you have some maybe Italian in you, some darker.
Yes.
Yes.
My grandfather's from Sicily.
Okay. The darker complected you are, the more that you just risk that you have a little bit more of a scarring that's more noticeable. Because essentially we're taking that off and it's creating little scars on the skin. But somebody who's really light, the scars are the same color as the skin. But it might be something that stays permanent, so that's something you want to seriously think about.
It's all right. I would rather have scarring than what I have.
Yeah. So that being said, I think we can do something about this. I'm actually very excited for you. I really feel like this is going to really help you.
I'm ready to do this.
All right, I'll be back, okay? I'll get some things together.
Thank you, doctor.
Of course. Oh my gosh, who brought him back? He's so cute. Do you see his outfit? He's like so put together, so you know he cares about his appearance. He has a pretty big case. It's got like grapes hanging off, but you can see them. Like you can see underneath them. All right, let's do it though. I'm excited about this one.
Yeah.
Dr. Lee is ready to jump in and help remove these low-hanging, crazy nodules. This is actually happening. But, you know, there's always a worry. There may be complications. You know, anything is possible.
I was wondering if we could have a little prayer before we start.
Absolutely.
Let me have your hand. Thank you. Lord, we pray that you would help us this day. Lord, thank you for Dr. Lee. We pray that you would give her every tool and that you would bless her efforts. And Lord, we are grateful for such skill. Amen. Thank you. I'm so thankful.
That's a lot of pressure.
The prayer was really sweet. I mean, I just met him, and here I am. I'm going to be working on his nose, on something that is bothering him greatly. And so he's just wanting to give me all the strength that he can possibly give me, and this is his way of doing it. Tony's nose is certainly unique, and I had to work in a more unorthodox way. My previous experience with rhinophyma really came in handy here. I'm very pleased with the results.
Ready?
Uh-huh. Oh, my goodness. Just amazing. There's my nose.
Yeah, your nostrils. Look at those nostrils.
When I look in the mirror, I see this normal guy and not this freakish blob of a troll-like nose. It's an amazing transformation. I cannot believe how good this looks.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, my goodness.
That's the underside of it. All that, I bet if I squeeze, would be some oil in there. So it would probably snap, crackle, and pop if you put it on something. Not that we'd ever put it on anything to cook.
It was shocking at how big those things were. When I would flare my nostrils in the past, there was all of this weight. There was all of this movement. Now, man, they're gone.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Give me a hug.
Oh, surely.
It's such a relief to be transformed. And there's, I don't think, anything that's going to hold me back now. Whatever public thing I need to do, I'm ready. I want to shout hallelujah, so hallelujah.